Wild Book is a book for children and young people, written by the novelist Juan Valoro. This book tells us about a boy who at the age of 13 faced the divorce that his parents were gradually carrying out, and as in the summer vacations, Juan was taken to his uncle Tito, an eccentric reader, who was quite isolated and only liked to read books and apparently had an addiction for pipe tea that, by the way, made him urinate too much. Meanwhile, Carmen, who was Juan's sister, was taken to her best friend and we won't know anything more about her for a while. Juan went to his uncle Tito and his mother gave him some coins so that he could communicate with him without the need to use uncle Tito's phone, a phone he did not like to use, since it did not allow him to read in peace. Juan was at first the opposite, since he was not a big fan of books, except for a few books. When he arrived, he was surprised, since his uncle had books everywhere. Uncle Tito had a maid, Frosita, who was in charge of cooking and cleaning. One day, John was surprised that the books seemed to be moving, so he went to his uncle Titus. His uncle explains to him that he has a special power with books and that is why moved when he is, and tells him that he is a princely reader, which is why he wanted to take care of him, because he already knew about his special talent and he wanted to know more about it, but his parents refused to leave him with him, that is, until they went through the divorce. Also, he explains that among all the books there is one called the Wild Book, and that book is so cold because Uncle Tito could never tame it. Juan is surprised by his talent, since he was not a fan of books, and it is then that he asks his Uncle Tito why this is so, to which he answers that books are the ones that choose their readers. I will pause here, because this part leaves us a very useful message, and that is that a reader can come from anywhere. In fact, we often read for fun, we read things on social networks or the internet, so I do not know why even so, there are people who do not like to read books considering that they read on the internet. And the fact is, we are all readers, and we can be big fans of reading like Uncle Tito if we give books a chance. It is not necessary to start with books like 1984, you can even start with children's books. Well, with all this said, let's continue. John sets out on the adventure to find the Wild Book. One day, when he wanted to go call his mother, and after asking Uncle Tito's permission, he goes to a public phone in a pharmacy in front of his uncle's house. It is then that he falls in love with Catalina, a girl who works in that pharmacy, is fond of reading, pretty, sweet, and Juan falls in love at first sight. When our two characters exchange a book called Journey Along the River in the Shape of a Heart, each one reads it and something happens. The story that a book tells us is not always the same, each reader adds something different, as I did when I gave him the message about reading a while ago, a message that I interpreted. And that's what happens when we read, because each reader's interpretation is different, something that gives rise to the version that each one transmits, and to the opinion that each one is of a book. And that, which I am not mentioning, is something that happens not only in books, but also in the media such as movies, television, internet, radio, among others. All of us, when we consume a product, have a different opinion, and we all have a different way of interpreting things, giving our version, and thus our opinion of those works that we consume. Another message that also intrigued me a lot is the message given on page 99, I will share it with you briefly. Yes, nephew, there are bad books. I don't mean the bad or ridiculous books, the sad books written by a person who suffered without that being useful, the books made by idiots who just wanted to be famous. No, I mean the books that hurt and attack other books. It is not easy to recognize them because they are cunning and hide their true message. If you read them, they may seem nice, but they make you forget what other books are saying. Great readers are not deceived, but sometimes even they accept this poison, made of forgetfulness and bad intentions. From this I can draw two conclusions. The first is that yes, not everything in terms of literature is good, and that is, many think that everything in terms of reading is good and something that enriches you intellectually, but that does not apply to all books. There are bad books, ridiculous books, books with questionable messages or very poor material, books that more than enrich you emotionally or intellectually, will simply waste your time. The second one is that it describes books as people, because there are people who can build our character or who can teach us new things, or who simply give us messages of encouragement, but there are other people who just talk nonsense and talk for the sake of talking, something that can be reflected in the authors of the books. For while they're authors who intend to give you a constructive message, executing it in an intelligent way so that you can entertain yourself, there are also authors who, out of a desire to be famous or to make money, write books with extremely poor content. The book also tells us all of the following. The attempts of the protagonists to have the Wild Book, the development of the courtship between John and Catherine, and how in one part these two kiss each other, and how Uncle Titus himself knew about the courtship, which both John and Catherine deny. In addition, we are told that Catherine's eyes hurt from reading too much, a rather interesting message, since although reading is enriching, it is true that there is a limit. Another thing we are told is a facet where Uncle Tito loves cooking, and he starts to experiment with dishes, all this based on different books. A little bit of background about Juan's family and evolution that Juan's parents have in the background. That's in addition to telling us when Carmen goes with Juan and his uncle, and Juan tells her that she will be taken to the supposed nightclub that he told her so much about to make Carmen jealous, making the meeting with the books. Also, we are told about Juan's and Uncle Tito's character development as a family, and how Uncle Tito learns to live together more, and how Juan also learns to do so, since Uncle Tito would like them to visit him, which in the end Juan promises they will. There is a part where Uncle Tito shows jealousy against Catalina, for which he apologizes, and there is a part where Catalina makes the hypothesis that the Wild Book is a book of the present. Since the books of the past are those already written and those of the future are those that will be written, but this one is of the present because it is still being written. And we are told that Uncle Tito was once about to read it, but he did not do so for fear of the portrait he would transmit. On the last day of vacation when his mother goes to pick them up, Juan and company finally manage to tame the Wild Book. Juan tells us all this is an anecdote, and he tells us that it happened later, like they moved not far from Uncle Tito and that Juan and Catalina got married. He ends up telling us how the Wild Book began and how this book that we have just analyzed began, both in the same way. This is the story of when I was 13 years old. And that's when he concludes with the following. But each reader will interpret things differently, the rest is up to you. Well, now let's analyze. This book has different messages, not only related to writing, but also to different areas. One of those messages is told to us on page 35 and it goes like this. To live with someone, you have to know what problems they can give you. No one is perfect. If you accept those problems, you will get along well. Another significant theme in this quote is understanding people, living with them, and what they go through. Juan sees himself in a difficult context, the divorce of his parents. Therefore, to live with Uncle Tito, a bibliophile and who spends much of his time urinating to drink pipe tea every minute. Juan has to conceive of what his uncle likes so much about. The books and because there are huge shelves in your house. When Juan is in search of the Wild Book, he takes help from his sister Carmen and her friend Catalina with whom he develops a friendship and maybe something else. This story is also very successful in the development of characters, because they cross obstacles but manage to get ahead. This book shows how the vast world of literature manages to be a lifesaver for the problems of everyday life. It gives us different analyses about the world of literature and of the media. The story is quite entertaining and can keep the viewer engaged. The story is seen from two human perspective, and it gives really wise phrases like, great readers add something to books, make them better. Besides, the ending is extremely surprising, and it's something I didn't really expect, making it unpredictable. Believe me, I looked everywhere for negative or reprehensible points, as I found them in The Knight in the Rusty Armor as it has narrative flaws as far as characters are concerned, but there's simply nothing wrong with it. For those with a closed mind it may be a cliché, but there's nothing cliché about it. In fact, it tries to reconstruct a concept, and it executes it in an ingenious way. A 10, I can't really blame him. It's a masterpiece, and if you're a writing enthusiast, or at least a casual reader, I would recommend that you read it.